Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Catherine Clayton. The International Space Station just received a fresh delivery of over 4 tons of science and supplies. Northrop Grumman's Cygnus cargo vehicle, NG-12, launched November 2nd from Wallops, Virginia. On November 4th, Expedition 61 astronauts Jessica Meir and Christina Cook used the space station's robotic arm to capture Cygnus. After the successful berthing, the work began to unload over 8,200 pounds of cargo inside the vehicle. While this is a record-breaking amount of cargo for Cygnus, the arrival of NG-12 is also the first time two Cygnus vehicles will be in orbit at the same time. NG-12 joins its predecessor, NG-11, which remains in orbit on an extended secondary mission to demonstrate this future capability. NG-12 will remain at the space station until January. This week, Boeing took a crucial step towards returning American spaceflight launch capabilities. Boeing's CST-100 Starliner spacecraft completed a critical safety milestone on Monday in an end-to-end test of its Abort system in White Sands, New Mexico. The test verifies that each of the Starliner safety systems functions separately and together to protect astronauts in the unlikely event of an emergency prior to liftoff by moving them safely away from the launch pad. During the two-minute test, the Starliner's launch abort engines and orbital maneuvering and altitude control thrusters fired to push the spacecraft about 1 mile above land and 1 mile north of the test stand. The successful pad abort test is another step towards achieving NASA's future missions. Activity outside the station will soon ramp up as the crew prepares for a series of spacewalks to repair the largest scientific instrument on the station. The Alpha Magnetic Spectrometer 2 is a subatomic particle detector that looks for dark matter, antimatter, and measures cosmic rays. AMS-2 took 16 countries nearly 20 years to develop and was installed on the space station in 2011. The repair of the AMS-2 cooling system will ensure that it can continue to provide more data and more groundbreaking science. Experts will discuss plans for the spacewalks and the future of AMS-2 in a series of briefings on Tuesday, November 12th on NASA TV and NASA.gov. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag AskNASA, and we'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.